My name is Louise McNamara, and this program is called All About You. This is the first in a series of programs. The purpose of them is to help you understand more about yourself and about other people, too. Haven't you sometimes wondered about questions like, what's inside me? What am I made of? What keeps me alive? And how did I get to be a baby? Why do I keep outgrowing my clothes? Why do my teeth fall out? What makes me get sick? What happens to all that food I eat? Why do I feel like running and skipping sometimes? Why do some people wear glasses and others wear hearing aids? Why do I feel the way I do? Sometimes mad, sometimes sad, or glad, or afraid. And why do I look like me and not like anybody else? And haven't you wondered, why do people keep telling you? Use your head. Use your head. Haven't you wondered about questions like these? I thought so. Well, together we're going to try to discover answers to your questions. And perhaps in the end, you'll know what you are, what makes you you, and what keeps you alive, and much, much more. Right now, here's a friend of mine that's going to help us. This is the Tin Man. The Tin Man is a robot. As you can see, he's made of, or supposed to be made of, machine parts. There are buttons and switches. He's made of cogwheels and axles and pistons and put together with nuts and bolts. Inside, he's made of springs and wheels and gears. What can he do? Oh, well, first watch and then tell me. What can he do? Yes, he can walk on 2 feet, swing his arms, make a noise, and he can go backwards as well as forwards, right. How many of these things can you do? Oh, you can? Show me. Stand up and do it, along with Mr. Tin Man. Ready? Okay, good. Now press your button and sit down again. You certainly can act like a robot or a machine. Now, does that make you a machine? Does it? Let me ask you another question. Can the Tin Man do all the things that you can do? Can the Tin Man cut with a pair of scissors? Can he hit a puck with a hockey stick? Can he jump rope? Can the Tin Man read a book? Can he write a letter? No, he can't do any of these things, can he? He can't even eat an ice cream cone, which is too bad. Why? Well, the Tin Man is a robot, and he's not alive. He's not alive, and he doesn't have a brain, but you do. Without a brain, he doesn't know what's going on around him. He can't think. He can't decide how to act, and he He doesn't have any feelings at all. Now, are you a machine? No way. Because the robot is not alive, and you are alive. In fact, you are more like this ivy plant than you are like the Tin Man, because the ivy plant is alive. Plants, flowers like the African violet, and fruits and vegetables like this tomato plant are alive too. They can't move around like you do, but they're alive and growing. Are you a plant, a fruit, a flower, a vegetable? No, of course not. Well, let's think, what other kinds of things are alive? Animals are alive, yes. There are many kinds of animals, and they come in all sorts of shapes and sizes. I'll bet you can think of lots of them. Big ones, small ones, some in between. And some are very tiny, like the animals in this pond water. Oh, they're in there. They really are. But they're so small that you can't see them without the help of a microscope. So let's take a microscope, which makes things look bigger than they really are, and take a look at a drop of pond water. I'll put just one drop on this glass slide, and then focus it so that I can see clearly. What you're going to be seeing is a cucumber-shaped animal called a paramecium. It's a very simple animal and very tiny. There it is. Can you see it? It's so simple, really, that it's hardly more than a blob of jelly. You can see the inside as well as the outside. You can see right through it. Now, here's another animal, one that you don't need a microscope to see. These furry animals, where are you? Hi, are called gerbils. Maybe you've seen gerbils before. This is peanut butter and jelly. The female gerbil is peanut butter and the male gerbil is called jelly. And they can eat and breathe, and as you can see, they can have babies. They have four babies who are only 10 days old. And they can move around and feel things happening to them. Hi. Would you like your nest back? There you are. Now, here's another animal friend of mine. This is Sandy. Sandy is a squirrel monkey. Hi, Sandy. Hi there. See his long tail? That's a prehensile tail. That's a big word, isn't it? Prehensile means grasp. With his tail, he can grasp or hold on to things just as well as with his hands. Hey, Sandy, psst, look, what have I got? Look at his hands. See? Tiny little hands. Sandy, want a cookie? Want a cookie? You deserve it. He'd rather exercise. Monkeys, gerbils, paramecia, cats and dogs. They're all animals. They're alive and growing. They can move around. And so can you. Are you an animal? Yes, you are. You're a very special kind of animal. You're a human animal. Oh, I know, you're people, but people are human animals. Now, if I say the word animal, what do you immediately think of? Do you think of a camel? Or a giraffe? Or a donkey? Or an elephant? You think of animals like these, don't you, instead of humans like yourself. I suppose that's because we're so different, and we know it. Human animals, that's you and me, can do so many more things than other animals like gerbils and monkeys can do. What kind of things? Well, things like these. Can't other animals do things like these, do the Mexican hat dance and build a tree house? Well, there are many reasons, but the most important reason is because they don't have brains like yours. They can't begin to do things with your brains, their brains, that you can do with your human brain. By now, you know that the brain is a very important part of the body. Well, what about the rest of your body? What's it like? How's it put together inside? If you weren't covered all over with skin and hair, it would be easy to know the answer, wouldn't it? But since you're not a paramecium, we have to look at a model of the human body in order to find out. If this is the first time you've ever seen a model of the human body, hang on to your hat. Let's go. Beneath the layer of skin on your chest are these bones. These are your rib bones. And lying behind the rib bones are your lungs. This is what you breathe with and what you blow up a balloon with. When you breathe in, fresh air goes into your lungs. And when you breathe out, the used air goes out. This, in the very center, see the shape of it? Is your heart, right? In your body, it's about as big as your fist, and its job is to keep your blood moving. It's a pump. Here is the liver. The liver is a storehouse for many of the important things that you need in order to stay alive. We'll take the liver out, and here's something that you say is empty when you feel hungry. What is it? That's right, the stomach. This is where your food goes after you chew it up with your teeth. In your stomach, it gets broken up some more, and then it goes into this long, winding, curling tube called your intestines. From the intestines, it goes out into your blood, travels all over, and gives you energy. The food that isn't used passes out of your body as waste when you go to the bathroom. Now, what about this organ up here that we've talked so much about? What is it? Yes, it's your brain. Right. What you have seen are some of the larger organs in the human body. There are other smaller ones, of course, and we'll talk about them another time. When you look at a model, you can't tell what the organs feel like. Soft and spongy like lungs, or firm like the heart, or liquid like the blood. But more important, when you look at a model, you can't tell what these organs do in a living body, because in a model, they aren't doing anything. So we have lots left to learn about them. Next time, we're going to be talking about a part of the human body that is harder than any plastic ever invented, that has over 200 pieces, and that grows as you grow. Do you know what it is? Can't guess? Okay, there's a puzzle for your brain.
All About You is a project of the Agency for Instructional Television.